he become old. I beg him. I beg him. Lift door open, and to his horror, he found me there. He stood stunned, speechless, and shaken. Blood drained from his face as he turned white to see. Anger he had inside. His fear faster than the hair of an artisan. Everybody. She refers to one of our neighbors as PCK from PCK. Portugal from Portugal. Because he was always very interested. Another neighbor is referred to as Sangi Echo. Because she has the most number of visitors in her house in our block. Of a cane or a bell, finding and jumping to the air. This little boy would scream in pain and beg in vain for the beating to stop. It still happened in his life. And the night before I met him was one of those things. I told myself I wanted to be a good neighbor. So I snorted. Telling myself it was not my business to interfere in his life. But as always, my body and what between my ears were not only just there. So I dropped on my knees. He pulled himself back to the corner of the lift even more. I continued. How badly did you do in your life? You upset your father in life. There was a sound from the place. They were lucky to reach the ground. I couldn't believe my ears when he said.
He was fifth in the class. Fifth in the class? He was treated like a punching bag because he was fifth in the class. What is wrong with you, ladies and gentlemen? In my family, fifth in the class would mean a family vacation. I understand the expectations are different in different homes. But I believe in this case, it has gone too far, too senseless, and too destructive for the relationship. The father had failed to realize that there was a cancer growing in the center of their relationship. If a child isn't loved and appreciated by his own parents, what kind of person he will grow up to be? If a child cannot learn to love his parents, what hopes does he have in loving others? If a child is plotting revenge against his own parents, what monster he can be to others? Ladies and gentlemen, we are all children of our parents and parents of our children. My message to you tonight is a simple but very important one. Let's make sure every child is loved, appreciated, and celebrated. Because I can promise you, this is the most important step in making a better family, a better society, and a better world. Ladies and gentlemen, I beg you, please don't give my wife another chance to call another child auntie.